Hello, everybody. It's my pleasure to share our research results. And the title of this research is Cancer Literature Classification Methods Performance. And my name is Chen Yuan Ho, and here are my co-authors. Before our presentation, please let me introduce myself because I'm seeking co-worker to work together, or maybe we can research, do some research for a topic together. Right now, I'm an associate professor in the Department of Computer Science and Information Engineering, Asia University, Taiwan. And here is my personal website. If you have interest in me, you can access my personal website to get more information. And right now, I have three research topics. The first one is artificial intelligence in applications. And the third is multipath TCP, or called MPTCP, and the TCP in caste problem research. And the third is the transportation analytics. And for the first research topic, I treat AI as a tool to solve the problem in other fields and to make them use AI technology to solve their problem in their field. For example, I use the AI prediction in semiconductor material, or use the prediction in transportation, and I have two industry projects and to solve their problem with AI and make their material or the device to have a longer health usage. Okay. And for the multipath TCP and the TCP in caste problem research is my major research here, because from my master and the PhD and to now, I always focus on TCP performance enhancement. And recently, I especially focus on the MPTCP here, because MPTCP can provide better quality of service than TCP, and it allows multiple interfaces to transmit data simultaneously. And TCP in case problem is usually happened in cloud data center, because in case is a many-to-one communication pattern, and this will let the performance down. So in this research topic, I want to solve the problem from incast and multipath. And for the third, transportation analysis, I use the transportation data in Taiwan, especially in Taichung, because Asia University is in Taichung. So I use them to make the traffic more smoothly and more quickly, and then get some suggestion to the government and let the government to design or to make a new policy of the transportation. Okay, and this is my introduction to myself, and let me come back to our research. And in this research, we focus on the cancer literature. So here is our outline about the abstract, introduction, procedure for classification, and our result and conclusions. For the abstract of our paper, this paper present the steps of cancer classification with three approaches: NAPBAG, neural network, and linear classifier with SGD training. The SGD means static generated dataset. And in our research, the results show the high model accuracy obtained by the NAPBAG and the neural network with the same value, 0.97. And that means if you want to do the cancer classification, you can use the NAPBAG or the neural network to do the cancer literature classifications. And this is the introduction for our paper. In our cancer literature, there are five types of cancer to classify, and all resource cancer literature or cancer paper that is extracted from the website of PubMed.gov, and with varied numbers and for each type, and the total number of the instance are 9,259. And the five types of cancer are like this five: the bone cancer, gastric cancer, kidney cancer, papillary cancer, and the skin cancer. And each number of the five types are shown here. This is the number of it. For example, there are 1,404 data in bone cancer, and 1,872 data in gastric cancer, and so on. And in our research, we use the project to do the cancer literature classification. And here are the six steps for this project. The first one is converting data from SML format to CSV format and doing vectorization and move stop words stream and do terms frequency inverse document frequency, or we can call TF, multiple IDF, and training and testing all data in a Python environment. And we will show our results and our step in the following slides. And we use the 80% of training data and the 70% training data or 60% of training data to do our literature, and use the renamed data to be the testing data, like the 20%, 30%, the 40%. Okay. And this is our procedure for the classification. The general step for building a classification model are like this. There are four steps. The first one is determine a classification scheme, and then reading test document, and the test pre-processing, and do the last step, classification. We see the first step. It can be like this one. Here is the classification scheme, and here we read in the test and do the pre-processing, and these are the three algorithms we use in our research and can do the classification and get the cancer type. And then for the second step, reading test document, and we have this number of instance and there are 9,259. So we reading the text and get the keyword and show here. And for the third, the text preprocessing. These are the text preprocessing code and the part of result. We can see the data extracting of abstract text and the article title. And this is the source code and these are the output. And then we have a lot of data and the extracted data, and then we merge the data like this one, data margin. And then when we made the problem, we need to do the troubleshooting, and finally we solve this problem. And this problem is the wrong data because the wrong data processing. So we do the troubleshooting here. And then this is the code for the data removing and to clean the data. And this is the TF multiple IDF, and we use the TF ID vector to analyze the data to do the transform. Okay. And the last step is the classification. And as talked before, and we use the 80% of data for our three approaches. So we will show the result here. The first one is the net buy with the normalization and with the 80% data training data and for the 20% testing data. And this is the model accuracy, the 0.89. And this is the score and the metric. And same as others, and so we can get the neural network with normalization 0.2, and we get the module x is 0.89, and its metric, and so on. So we will quickly show the slide here, like the linear classification with 0.2, and we get the module x 0.89, and the metric, and then net bear with 0.3, that means 70% of training data, and we can see the accuracy is still 0.89, and so on. Neural network 0.3, the accuracy and the metric, and the linear classification with 0.3, the accuracy metric, and the last part is the three approach with 0.4. You can see here, and the neural network and the linear classification. Okay, and then we get this result, and we can collect the above result and analyze them. So for example, we collect all the accuracy from the three approach with 80%, 70%, and 60% training data, and we call a method here, three approaches, and this means by the 80% training data, 70% training data, and 60% training data, we can see that each method shows the same performance with the same accuracy here. But if we see the performance with the different accuracy, we can see the number and the neural network accuracy will improve to 0.97 when the training data is 70% and 30% testing data. here. Okay. And then we see the confusing matrix, and we can see that no matter which data set or which algorithm, we can get the kidney cancer is the highest one in than others. Okay. And we can see the result indicate the type of cancer with the largest instant will show the highest accuracy here. So the kidney show the highest accuracy 0.2. Okay. And the performance with the 60% are similar like to the 0.3 and the 0.2. And here is the incorrect instant result here. And we can see that the orange color is the correct instance, and the purple color is the most incorrect instance. And this table indicates the highest missed classification of each cancer. And this, you can see that when you have the kidney cancer and the pancreatic cancer, that become the lowest number of the missed classification. And you can see that when you have the kidney and the bone, this is a 0.2, and the bone and the grass is 0.07, and so on. And we can see that if you have the same, and your the performance will be the highest. And if you use a data, the kidney is not the very good. You can see that the most incorrectly instant are happen in the kidney cancer here, or like here. And let me conclude our research. The first conclusion is the incorrect instant can be caused by the relationship between two different cancer types. And the example is like the bone cancer and the gastric cancer caused by the relation of the research topic of both cancer. That usually breast cancer initially present as the bone first. And the second is we want to treat the cancer survivor will use a lot of medicine, and that will harm the patient's liver, and the kidney cancer will be the most common cancer effect in the patient. And this case bias with the pancreatic cancer and the wherein with the 0 to 0.01, and maybe this will be wrong as the pancreatic cancer. And this is our presentation. Thank you very much. And if you have any problem, please contact me via the email tommyho@asia.edu.tw. Thank you very much.